Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2671, DeepSeek versus Copilot head-to-head. All right, today I'm going to test two different things. First off, formula creation, same formula I ask every new LLM. I have a column of numbers, tell me if they're prime numbers. I will test this with DeepSeek and Copilot. And then test number two, formula explanation. Here's a really complex formula created by Excel Lambda. Try and explain to me what it's doing so I can understand the workbook. Here we go. All right, let's compare formula creation. In DeepSeek here, I'm explaining that I have a column of integers starting in B2 and extending to B547. The integers are always positive numbers between 1 and 5,000. I need a formula to detect if the number in column B is a prime number. All right, and they're offering either a helper column approach or an array formula approach. With the helper column, starting from C2, this formula is going to list all possible divisors for the number in B2. So I have to drag it across. Now they say, I have to drag it far enough to cover all possible divisors up to the square root of 5,000, which is approximately 70. So column Z should suffice. And then in, let's say, column AA, a formula to check if any divisors were found. Now, this is good. I actually appreciate that they're suggesting this method, even though this isn't the method I'm going to use today. I've used it in the past in another episode of the podcast. I can kind of use this to figure out that they're trying to get a list of all of the possible divisors and then checking them. But then they give me a single cell approach, and that's, of course, the way that we're going to use here. Now, they're still telling me to press Control-Shift-Enter. Of course, we don't have to do that anymore. So copy that and paste in here. Double click to copy it down. I know that I have a lot of prime numbers in this list, and in checking it, it's doing really well, but it's failing the same way that a lot of these LLMs will fail, where it's not getting 2 and 3 correct. But at least since they really seem to know what's going on here, I came back and said, all right, this does not work for the specific case where the number is 2 or 3. Do you have an alternate formula? And then they're correct. I am correct. What a great way to butter me up. I am correct. Now, the previous formula may not handle the cases of 2 and 3 because the divisor range calculation can behave unexpectedly for small numbers. So let's refine the formula to handle all cases, including 2 and 3. Like, why didn't you do this from the beginning? I told you that the numbers could start at 1. But then they give me a formula here. Copy that formula and paste that in. So it's basically just hard coding for 2 and 3, recalling those prime, and then everything else above 3. It's working, and that formula works really well. All right, so let's come here to Copilot, and we'll ask Copilot to create a formula. Oh, no. Of course, Copilot can't do this because I don't have autosave turned on, and it's stored with all my other podcast files. It's not stored in the cloud. I really am not a fan of having to turn this autosave on. It's just a terrible, terrible limitation. I won't work in Excel if I have to have autosave on. Come back to the Copilot Skittle. Suggest a formula column. I guess I'm going to ask Copilot. Add a column to detect if the integer in column C is a prime number. So they suggest a formula here. We'll insert that column. All right, the formula is returning reference errors. Let's get explain the error, suggest a fix. That's funny, it started Did you see that? I'll have to go back in the video. It started to suggest it. I'm not able to do that. Okay, so the formula created. Column C is working in C2, but is returning errors in the other rows. Can you suggest an alternate formula? All right, so here's an alternate formula. I guess I'm supposed to copy it to the clipboard. Equal sign, paste. Okay, same issue that it's not getting 2 and 3. This formula is not working for the specific case where the integer is 2 or 3. Can you suggest an alternate formula that will handle these specific cases? Okay, so let's compare these. The Copilot formula took 3 tries, and the DeepSeek formula . All right, so Copilot's returning true or false, DeepSeek's returning prime or not prime. Other than that, they seem to be pretty much equivalent. All right, so then the question is, all right, DeepSeek, 2 tries. Excel took 3 tries. Other than that, though, just about a tie. I guess the big question, really, given the tie, it's do you want to have to turn AutoSave on or not? If you're okay working in AutoSave and just, you know, destroying things when you forget to save as, then that's great. Probably Copilot. If you're like me and you hate AutoSave, then DeepSeek would probably be the way to go. All right, another thing that both of these items do, both Copilot and DeepSeek, will explain Excel formulas. I have this Excel formula sent in by Excel Lambda. It's from a few months ago. I don't really remember what we were trying to do. And so if I come here to Copilot and say, explain this formula, all right, now, while it's working on that, one great thing here is I can just do this right from the Excel file. And with DeepSeek, I'm going to have to describe the Excel file. But then the con in Excel is that in order to use Copilot, I have to save it to OneDrive. And the super dangerous thing is to turn AutoSave on. I will never do this with production data. So, you know, like, Copilot's never a thing for me. I actually like the fact that DeepSeek now doesn't require me to have AutoSave turned on. And the problem with AutoSave On, of course, is that I'm going to, you know, do some what-if analysis, and it's going to save it. And I don't want to save it until I click Save As. Okay, so over here, it says that this formula creates a pivot table-like summary of data and then removes the first row of the resulting array. So it says that it's going to group data in C4 to C1165. By the values in B4 to B1165, aggregates the data from D using the concat function, no field headers, no total depth, and no column total depth, and then removes the first row. All right, so that's a pretty clinical explanation of what's going on. Let's compare that. Okay, now for DeepSeek, I've taken the worksheet and saved it as an XLSX file. file, and we're going to upload that. And then for the prompt, we have an Excel workbook, list of songs by workout ID, track number starts in B3, workout ID is in C3, artist song is in D3, there's an array formula in G4. Can you explain this formula and suggest what it is trying to do? All right, look at this. It's going through the Excel file, providing a syntax of pivot by, syntax of concat, syntax of drop. But then what I really like is that in down here, what the formula does, it says it's a concatenated artist song values for each combination of workout ID and track number. It's likely trying to create a summary table where each row represents a workout ID and each column represents a track number. The cells in the table contain the concatenated list of artist song values for the specified workout ID and track number, and then removes any header or unnecessary information, leaving only the summarized data. I think this is a great summary of what this workbook is doing, and just uploading the file. I never had to turn AutoSave on. I don't have to change my workflow. I don't even have to save it to OneDrive. Is it as convenient as having it right in Excel? Yeah, probably not. But to avoid having to turn on autosave, it's probably worth it to me. All right, so we have two tests. Formula creation, DeepSeek gave me multiple choices, and it got a working formula in two tries. Copilot, complete fail on try one, got a working formula in three tries. Formula explanation, Copilot was able to explain the syntax. DeepSeek, it was a friendlier explanation. So we come down to intangibles. Microsoft is built right into Excel. You can't beat that. DeepSeek does not require autosave to be turned on. I just pushed back on the Excel team. It's like, why? Why do we really need autosave turned on? I understand you have to be saved to OneDrive. I don't have a problem with that. But the autosave on, that really seems like something that's not necessary, and it's a reason why I won't use Copilot. I just don't want autosave on. And then the big intangible, privacy. Who do I trust more? I mean, Microsoft has a privacy policy that I trust, and DeepSeek, I know nothing. Costs, Microsoft. Copilot is almost as much as Microsoft 365, and DeepSeek right now, I haven't paid anyone, and I'm getting all these answers. What are the costs going to be for DeepSeek? Since I recorded the video this morning, I've had two questions come in that I was not able to solve, and so I went to a large language model, and the model that I used, it was DeepSeek. Wow, okay, that was fun, DeepSeek versus Copilot. But in our next episode, it's going to be even more exciting. We have three of the smartest Excel formula people I know versus Copilot, versus DeepSeek, versus the Copilot beta, head-to-head. Who will win? Tune in to episode 2672 tomorrow. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.